If you own a Hummer H2 and your front windscreen wiper motor sounds like this, then it may be time for a new motor. One of these, one I've ordered earlier. So I'm going to show you how to remove the panels over the wiper motor. You're going to need a plastic tool to actually prise off the two bump corners. I think we're going to need a Phillips and probably a 13mm spanner. Here we go. As you know, on Hummer H2, you've got these bump corners, as I call them. I'm not quite sure what the real name is. There's two of them on either side, very distinctive. We're going to put our tool underneath this part here and gently prise it up. Can't do it while I'm holding the camera, so I'll pop them off and then we'll explore further. So underneath each bump corner is a Phillips head screw. Just take them off like this, looking after the screws, put them somewhere safe. And then the next thing is to prise this grill off. Now I have to say that the grill is not the easiest thing to get back on. Comes off really easy. Getting it back is a little bit of a challenge. So we'll do the other side and then we get to the grill. Now normally on the cover are some plastic pins. They're like a kind of plastic rivet with a locking ring or something on there, which goes through here. They're absolute devil to get off without the right tool. So I've left mine off. I don't see any point for them. The thing is secure, it's never going to come off. So I've left those off and they're going to stay off. After a little bit of wiggling, I've got the cover off, and basically you've got these clips underneath the sides here. I don't know if you can see them. I think there are four clips which line up with these holes here. The trick is to pull it up from the windscreen side and then guide the hole in the cover here over here, and then you can pull the other ones out. It's a bit of a twist, but it does come out, and there we have the wiper motor as it stands. We're going to go to the other side and have a look at the bolt that holds it together. To make life easier, I've just taken off the water pipe from the front grill and put it to one side. You can now see the motor with its connector, which is easily removed, I think. I think you have to put a screwdriver underneath the other side or do something. Oh, that just comes off. There we go. Now the question is, can we take the motor off without removing the whole assembly? I didn't want to move the whole assembly because of the windscreen wiper motor alignment. I didn't want to actually change the positions or alter anything. But it may be that we have to do that. There's two ways we can do it. We can either take that plate off and the arm, which would keep the datum, or just try and remove the motor. See if I can feel the nut on the back of the motor. Now I'd imagine that these motors can park in the home position for the wipers, but just to make sure, I've plugged the motor in and turned on the wipers and let it do a rotation. And just be careful that it's a bit jumpy when there's no load on it. There's quite a lot of inertia in the motor, and when it stops it jumps about. But I now know that this motor should be in the same home position as the one we're about to take off. Okay, it seemed way too hard to get the motor nut off with it in place, so I've decided to take the assembly off. I've put witness marks on with a felt tip pen around the points. I also noticed that that bolt in the middle there is very close to the front edge of that washer. It's actually, if you undo that, it pushes back, so there's a little bit of tension on there. So hopefully we'll get this off and be able to put it back in the same position. Right, the wiper arm assembly has now been removed. This is the underside of the motor. There's some Torx screws on there, which I'm not sure if they actually are screws or just posts. The reason why I say that is that the new one has got no tapping inside. They're either self-tapping torque screws or just pillars, just to stop it rotating. We're now looking at it as if we're in the driver's seat, and this is the driver's side, left-hand side of the vehicle, and right-hand side of the vehicle. I noticed that there's a lot of play in this bush on this side. Whether that's intentional or just wear, I don't know. This one is fine. So, could just be there's a bit of float in there, don't know. So I'm going to try and take this motor off, and we'll undo that. I think it is a 13mm nut on there. Yes, it is. I've already loosened it. So here we go. How we get the motor off now, I'm not too sure. I might have to drift it off a little bit. Now, as you can see, there is a spline on the motor, which goes into this tang here. Huh. It's going to be hard to replicate that position, methinks. Should have marked it before I took it off. Still, it's done now. We'll see if we can recover the situation. Fortunately, because I've been taking videos, I've been able to recover the position of the arm on the motor and the spline. And I've outlined it in that, with a blue felt tip pen. So I'm pretty sure, because of the spline, it can only be in a few degrees of one place or another. It's not infinitely variable. So everything else looked wildly out. So my aim is to get this position as close to where it is now as possible. One thing has become clear, and that is that the need to remove this is proven. You wouldn't be able to get this motor off without taking this assembly off, that's for sure. And it does look like these Torx screws have locked the motor in place. Now, to get the tang off was quite easy. You just put a flat blade underneath there and just tap it through. And it just popped straight off. It wasn't difficult to get off. So that's not hard. Being somewhat lazy, I've broken the tightness of the screw, and I'm going to use an electric screwdriver to remove the box. I'll do that off camera. Right, I've determined that it is actually an M6 tap that fits in there. As you can see, that goes in. So I'm going to tap my my new one, M6, so that the screws go right in. Don't have to struggle with those. That seems either an omission on the manufacturer of these, or something that they do on the factory floor, but we're gonna tap it anyway. Okay, the die-cast material is really soft. It tapped really easily, which suggests that the screws would self-tap, but I still prefer to pre-tap the holes. It makes assembly a lot easier. I've used an M6 spiral tap with some cutting fluid, and I've tapped that hole, as you can see. The screw now goes in really easily. I think it's a lot easier to do it that way. That's what I prefer. I've got a spiral tap, which means you don't have to keep winding it forward and then backing off to break the swarf. This will tap in a single operation, which makes life really easy. I'm going to continue and do the remaining two holes. With all three holes tapped, I've refitted the motor and put the Torx screws back in. They tightened up really nicely, and so the motor is now mounted. All that's remaining is to put the arm back on. I fitted the tang back on, Notice the position has changed, because as you tighten it up, you actually turn the motor. It's almost unavoidable. I've also fitted a washer under the nut, because I'm old school. I always put a washer behind the nut, just to help even the force out. Stops it coming in and down. So all that remains now is to go and put this back in the vehicle. I've refitted the assembly. It's a good job I left pen marks, witness marks, because it is easy to put this in a different position. Before I put the blades on, I'm just going to make sure that the actual mechanism rotates. It's also easy when you're putting this back together to get these arms in the wrong positions. You know, it's quite a free movement and you can easily get those wrong. So hopefully I've got them right. That's the right hand side and the left hand side. We're now just going to, before I put the blades on and things go all to pot, we're just going to see if it actually homes and goes back to the right place. The wiper system's been homed, and fortunately the wiper blades have left their own witness mark on the screen, so I can tell that they're now going back. I didn't clean the screen beforehand, so I can tell they've gone back to pretty much the same position that they were before we started. And we're just going to give it a test. We'll put out key and ignition. Try the blades. That sounds a whole lot different to when we started. That looks fine to me. As long as the cover goes back on, we'll be okay. There might be a tiny fraction of a... Now that clunk you can hear, I think it's to do with the being that, as I was saying before, Android Auto rudely interrupted my video. The play, or the clunk that you can hear, I think is to do with either some play in the spline on the mechanism, or that looseness that I showed earlier. It's always been there. I think the previous owner tried to put some tape on there around the spline to stop it clunking, but in fact it probably made the situation worse. So that's a job for another day, but at least we now have got back to square one. All we've got to do is reassemble all the components.